Greetings, fellow. Thanks for welcome to Delta Force, or rather, welcome back to Delta Force. Today's mission at hand is Shutdown, which is, I think, the penultimate mission for the Indonesia campaign. Could be more, I have no way of knowing for sure. But anyhow, today's mission at hand is Shutdown, and the objective is pretty simple. Just pacify all the enemy forces like a baby. We'll be carrying a pacifier gun which shoots out lots of pacifiers to... Well, basically pacify them. Anyway, let's just go ahead and read the briefing. Ooh, it's formed in sort of a V formation. That is a lot of enemies, but okay. Eliminate all enemy forces at a terrorist base designated objective Eaton. I have a feeling this is going to be pretty difficult. You will be inserted into a position approximately 380 meters north of objective Eaton. Follow your checkpoint south into the objective. You are authorized to eliminate all enemy forces you encounter during this mission. This mission will be considered a success when once the entire objective has been pacified. I wonder why they keep saying pacified instead of neutralized. But anyway. Expected enemy forces. For this mission, an NSC satellite was specially tasked to observe the terrorist base. From these images, J2 has been able to verify a force strength of approximately 2 platoons at the objective. So how many people is that? 48? Who knows? 60? Maybe. Also clearly visible in the satellite image was a Gazelle attack helicopter. Oh no. So I'm guessing we'll have to carry the law. And we'll have to lay down the law when the Gazelle comes to attack us. I wonder if I can just get a peek at the Gazelle. I see. Anyway, allied support. Alpha team will be inserted into position approximately 610 meters east of the objective. They are tasked with suppressing all enemy perimeter patrols in the hills east of the objective. They will be failing at it, of course. But they will then support your attack on the objective. Charlie team will insert approximately 690 meters southwest of the objective. They will neutralize all enemy perimeter patrols along the western flank. When they have accomplished that task, they will move into position overlooking the objective and support your assault. So basically, the plan, the proposed plan, which of course will, you know, never go as planned, which will never go as planned, is that Alpha team would attack from this side and Charlie team would attack from this side. And we will be coming from over here, over yonder. So, one of the questions that I've always wondered is how do they manage to insert me, since one is the insertion point, how is it they manage to insert me so close into the camp, but Alpha and Charlie have to, you know, begin their incursion into the camp from much farther distances, which, you know, is more realistic. I mean, my entry points always seem pretty unrealistic to me, considering how there are so many new patrols around. So, anyway. When they've accomplished that task, they will move into position overlooking the objective and support your assault. The same as Alpha team, basically. Situation: the IMT has claimed responsibility for several bombings within the cities of Patankaraya and Kandavangan. I hope that is how you say those names. I'm pretty sure I'm butchering them, but okay. They claim the bombings are in retaliation for the various losses they have suffered since our operations began, and since they will continue to escalate the bombings until all non-Indonesians have left the country. Reconnaissance overflights have located an IMT base between these two cities. The destruction of this base should end all IMT activities within the three largest islands of Indonesia. Let me just go ahead and check here. Now, for this mission, I'm a little confused between whether to go for this rifle or this rifle. Because on the one hand, the scope really helps, but on the other, this thing is amazing. So I might, you know, appreciate the volume of firepower, but let me just go ahead and check this mission out first. Maybe if it requires a lot of long range encounters with precise targets, then yeah, I'll, you know, stick with this. Otherwise, I'll switch over to the other weapon. Spec Ops 45 is correct. I was wondering whether or not I should go for the double load ammo, but I suppose the helicopter can be taken out with just bullets as well in this game. It'll be a little more difficult, but it's nothing impossible, I suppose. Anyway, moving on, let's go and start up this mission then. Should take me a fair few tries, probably 15 to 20 tries, and about 1 to 2 hours to complete, but let's see. Let's hope it doesn't take that long. And yeah, yet again I get taken out by a stray bullet. There's like, yeah, this would be off. There should be another person coming up from over there. Come on, come on, come on. Item number 3 or 4, I'm guessing, yeah, I guess. Item number 4, probably. Should be a few more people coming from here.
Bravo team, move into the camp. Alpha and Charlie, secure the perimeter.
Roger, King 6.
Roger, King 6.
Where are these people? Wait, did they just cross me from behind? That was funny. I was waiting for them in ambush and they just crossed me
in position
from behind. Leaving me wondering as to, wait, where are these folks? Anyway, head in the game now. Now, these actually provide pretty good cover in this game, these trees and other foliage. However, I'm a little afraid of using them because every time that you use these trees for cover, I guess that guy's dead. And what about you, dear sir? Good sir. I suppose it won't be as easy to kill you. Okay, that those shots are getting a little close. Closer than I would want them to. This person is, you know, taking the long route around just to get to me. I will see you. I will see you and I will raise you.
Charlie, Alpha team is down.
That is quite unfortunate, King 6. Pass on my condolences to the family, please. Yeah, I just wanted to cover all of my bases before I went ahead and, you know, died to that one person. But that's what that was about. Alpha team usually typically dies here. So it's nothing new. You're dead. Thank you for coming, though. Where are these people? I don't think these people are being a nuisance at the moment, but we will have to come back and take care of them later. The biggest nuisance, however, are the people, you know, inside the village. Once the helicopter takes off, the rest of the mission just goes to shit. So, we have to be pretty careful with how you're playing it. Because it's pretty easy to... That. Yeah, so it's, you basically have to be really careful with how you play it, like keep relocating before you actually shoot. And the chopper takes a surprising amount of shots to take down. I mean, I would have preferred to have a law for this mission, just because of that. Just because of the fact that the chopper takes an obscene amount of bullets. I think like around 3 magazines or so. But, well, whatever gets the job done, I suppose. It should be somewhere down there, like somewhere down there. Somebody is shooting at me at this point, or maybe they're shooting at Charlie, I do not know. These people, however, never seem to notice me as I begin my assault at them. Should be one more person over there. And even though this person sees me, he never attacks me. So yeah, that's that. Should be somebody in that place over there. I can hear some shooting here and there. Yeah, the chopper is now finally taking off. Let the chopper take off. I will shoot them when it is convenient for me. Yeah. Come on, chopper. It's just you and me, buddy. Roger, King 6. Chopper is down. I'm just going to slowly retreat.
Chopper's out!
And I'm going to circle around. and approach this new target from a new position, from a position where they're not exactly expecting it, because there are other enemy forces in the area as well, and they tend to be pretty lucky with their shots. So I just want to go somewhere where I won't be so easily exposed to their firing, to their shooting, so to speak. And this seems like a nice enough place. I see you. Anybody there? Oh yeah, there is. There are a few people there. Let's just go ahead and use this to take them out. Lots of people here. There should be somebody down there. Should be somebody, or maybe down there. Or maybe that's the person that I was looking at. So those, all of those spaces are empty then. Yeah, confirmed. All of those spaces are empty. Let me just keep going around and scouting out this area as well as I can. Trying to keep a tab on all the enemies located here. Four people dead. Now, one of the good things is that right now they're not firing at me. So, which is pretty much a blessing. Because if they start, why aren't these barrels exploding? That guy died with a pretty...
There's one in the tower, watch the tower!
Which tower? This tower? No. I took that person out. Okay, I can see somebody approaching. Like, on the map, I mean. I can't exactly see them approaching. Ouch. Is there some... Ah, somebody's in the nest. And that person got lucky. And I think that is Charlie, whichever number it is, with the support. Now, one of the things that I dislike about this game is how... the enemies can sometimes, hide behind stuff like tents.
Charlie 2 is down!
Oh no. Oh wait, that's just Charlie 2. Okay. Alpha Team is down and Charlie 2 is down. That's fine thus far, I suppose. There should be somebody over there. Nobody over there. I just need to proceed with a little bit of caution. I can't exactly drop shot people in this game, being one of my regrets. Eternal regrets. Oh! I think Charlie killed those people. How nice of Charlie, how considerate, son. I was about to call Charlie boy, but then I remembered. Wait, maybe it's more appropriate if I call him son instead. But where is Charlie, I wonder? He's over there, of course. I'll just set the objective marker to the next objective. And there are a few people here, probably at the inside this tent, I suppose. I just hope that the game does not crash here like it has been doing for the past few times that I've gotten close to objective markers. They are inside those tents, of course. Maybe it's time for me to utilize a more aggressive approach. One last person there. That person seems to be waiting for me at this point. Wherever he is. And I don't really like this range, Like, I can't see where this opponent is. Huh, thank god for the extra round. Oh no, I accidentally closed the mission without reading the statistics or pretty much, even going through the messages. But yeah, that did not take as much time as I thought it would. Another thing that I discovered recently. You can pause the game by using the pause button on the keyboard, which is right next to your delete button. I think these buttons are, being removed from your keyboards because they're never used, but I had never thought that I would ever see a pause button being used like this, because I've never seen it being used like this ever since I started gaming. I mean, I've tried doing this in Delta Force 2, Delta Force 3, Road Rash, they never use the pause button like this. So yeah, discovery for me. Anyway, so let's just go ahead and see, read the mission statistics. Sorry about that. I thought there would be, you know, more action on this mission. Mission statistics. 0 kills, obviously. Probably killed quite a few people, but I don't think the number was anything greater than 20 or so. Bravo team has successfully neutralized the enemy base. The destruction of this base has successfully freed all of Indonesia's southern and western islands of the IMT. Based on the information provided by members of the IMT captured trying to flee the base. Oh, I see, there were people who were still alive. I suppose all the people, you know, running about, out and about. J2 believes they may have identified the location of the IMT base where the stolen CDC materials are being held. Preparations for Bravo team's recovery of those bioagents is underway at this time. I see. Did that unlock a new mission? No, it did not. I wonder if it'll unlock after I finish this mission instead of lockdown. Capture the commander of terrorist base designated objective more. Now, the question is, if I finish this mission, would I automatically get the vials of the, you know, viruses obtained from the CDC as well? Or would I actually have to complete one more mission for that? I'm hoping it's one more mission because I am enjoying this game thus far, despite all the frustrating aspects of it. Especially considering all the times that you have to retry the game. But yeah, thus far it has been good and I would like to keep it so. So yeah, the next time we approach this game and the next time we log on, we will be completing Operation Lockdown. Thank you for watching Operation Shutdown today, and until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.